Hello viewers, welcome once again to our episode regarding the iconic figure of Bengal, that is Mr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. We really appreciate your association, your patience and your understanding that we are working regarding a certain personality who has really shaped the picture of Bengal. While I say that, we really request you to watch our channel that is a national icon. And our page, that is the Shyama Prasad Enlightenment Federation.
Now, No Kali riots aftermath. Coming to it, as a result of the riots, around 50,000 people were rendered homeless. Many fled to other areas due to the massacre and forced conversions. Refugees were sent to Calcutta, although the migration of people stopped after relief measures were brought in. It started again after the partition of the country was announced. This time, the refugee influx was into Assam, Tripura and the areas that became West Bengal.
Hello viewers, welcome to the team National Icon. I hope you are all doing well in this COVID-19 situation. So today, let's talk about Noakhali riots. So in Noakhali village, he met helpless people, molested women and Hindu families still in hiding, primarily the poor, and as most of the rich families who were not killed has fled their villages, Gandhi invoked fearless, while Hindu Mahasabha leaders sitting in Calcutta and outside Bengal were demanding a military protection for besieged population. Gandhi was one-man military. He walked door to door and village to village, comforting and giving helpless courage.
Even though the violence started on the 10th, enforcers were sent to the affected areas only on the 14th. An earlier intervention from the government might have prevented thousands of deaths. It is estimated that about 5,000 Hindus were killed during this riots. Thousands were forcibly converted and many women were raped. Property was ransacked and houses and shops looted and burned. Temples were desecrated.
Aspects. of communal ideology was also the assertion of the moral rights of every individual to profess or follow any religion as long as it did not negatively affect other religious creed.
This visit was represented by Muslim League minister, the Muslim League worker, the local Malvas and even larger number of common Muslim villagers under communal swag. The massacre of Muslim in Bihar as a reaction of Noakhali was also used to protect his village to Noakhali. And he was asked by none less than Chief Minister of Bengal Shurabardi himself to leave. The villagers threw night soil on the narrow and slippery village's path. They dug up the narrow waterlogged road so as they could not work. And yet Gandhi, a frail man, 77 years of age, was determined. He answered his detractors by walking barefoot, sending away his companions, sleeping every night in different villages, taxing his body even more. And as if it's challenging them to do their maximum, but it could not deter him. Not only that, he himself showed not fear, but he told people to shed their fears and to the confront.
Lal Mohan Sen, a revolutionary leader who had participated in the Chittagong Armory raid and had been in prison for 16 years by the British, was killed by a mob during the riots. The League government tried to carve incidents of violence being reported in the newspapers. It also covered up a report on the Noakhali incidents by Edward Skinner Simpson, a retired judge. Many Indian social and political organizations came for relief activities. Among the organizations were Bharat Sevashram Sangha, ILC, the Communist Party of India, Hindu Mahasabha, the Indian National Army of Bose, Arya Samaj, etc.
He saw forcible marriage and forcible conversations and also the lie to attempt scare people. On 12 November at Dattapada, he said he has seen the terror-stricken face of suffer. They has been forcibly converted once and they would afraid the same thing would be treated. He know the communal ideology wins by insisting fear and therefore he attacked the atmosphere of fear.
Mahatma Gandhi visited the disturbed areas to spread his message of non-violence and request the rioters to stop. Although he largely failed in his objective, his presence did bring in some calm. He saw these riots as a taste of his principle of ahimsa. When Shuravardi tried to evade a charge of murder on his government, the normally calm Gandhi said in anger, "Yes, you are responsible not only for that murder, but for every life lost in Bengal, whether Hindu or Muslim."
He was particularly angry at the way the male population of many villagers ran away, leaving their mother, wives, sister and daughter to confront the molesters. In the same manner, he chastised the so-called upper class leaders, questioning their right to speak as leaders when they themselves ran away, leaving the lower caste vulnerable peoples. He wanted peoples not to depend on others but to faith in themselves in such a situation that if they had not done to remember God.
We have our Facebook channel, that is Shyama Prasad Enlightenment Federation, and our YouTube channel National Icon, where we put all these documents from history in our audio-visual format. We request all of you to go through this precise historical depiction to make sure you know the history of Bengal properly. And it's not only you, we suggest all of you to share this information to your near and dear ones to make sure that history is known and history is not distorted. Let's take care of our people, know the history and share the vision. Thank you so much.